Hello students, welcome to online computer classes. Myself Dr. Kajal Rai, and today we are going to discuss about OSI model. OSI model is Open System Interconnection model. So let's start. This OSI model is divided into 7 layers. The layer architecture is used to reduce the design complexity. The basic idea of a layered architecture is to divide the design into small pieces. Each layer adds to the services provided by the lower layers in such a manner that the highest layer is provided a full set of services to manage communications and run the application. The benefit of the layered models are modularity and clear interfaces, that is open architecture, and comparability between the different provider components. There are several elements of layered model. Let us discuss some of the basic elements of layered model. First basic element is service. A service is a set of actions that a layer offers to another layer. The next basic element is protocol. A protocol is a set of rules that a layer uses to exchange information with a peer entity. These rules concern both the contents and the order of the messages used. Next basic element is interfaces. Between the layers, services interfaces are defined. The messages from one layer to another are sent through those interfaces. So these are the basic elements of a layered model. Now let's start with the OSI reference model. As we all know about the name, Open System Interconnection Model. This OSI model was developed by the ISO, International Organization for Standardization, in 1984. The OSI reference model describes how information from a software application in one computer moves through a network medium to a software application in another computer. OSI model is a conceptual model composed of 7 layers, each specifying particular network functions. These are the 7 layers, as you can see on the screen: physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, and application layer. These are the 7 layers, and we will start from the physical layer first. But before start, I will like to tell you that we will discuss this OSI model and each of the layers, but only the main functions of each of the layer. We will not go into deep in this video, and if you want to see the overall the functioning of each layer in detail, then wait for the upcoming videos. We will study each layer in detail in the upcoming videos. So let's start with the main functioning of each layer. First is the physical layer. Physical layer controls the transmission of the actual data onto the network cable. It defines the electrical signals, line states, and encoding of the data and the connector types used. For example, 10BASE-T. The physical layer is concerned with the transmission of raw bits over a communication channel. After the physical layer, there is a data link layer. This layer takes the data frames or messages from the network layer and provides for their actual transmission. At the receiver computer, this layer receives the incoming data and sends it to the network layer for handling. This layer also provides error-free delivery of data between the two computers by using the physical layer. It does this by packaging the data from the network layer into a frame, which includes error detection information. The goal of the DLL or data link layer is to provide reliable, efficient communication between adjacent machines connected by a single communication channel. Next is the network layer. But before going to the network layer, I would also like to tell about the data link layer, that besides the error-free delivery, it also do the flow control. Flow control means it prevents a fast sender from overwhelming a slow receiver. Now, the network layer. The network layer is responsible for addressing messages and data so they are sent to the correct destination, and for translating logical addresses and names into physical addresses. As we all know, we don't know where the location of the physical computer is, but we know the IP address, or we can say the name domain system which is given to us. That, for example, if you want to send some mail to some Gmail account, then you know that the address of the Gmail account or mail, and you don't know where that system is, but you sent the mail and the receiver got it and checked the mail. So the physical address is handled by the network layer where the location is. This layer is also responsible for finding a path through the network to the destination computer. As the network layer knows where it has to reach, then so it find the route also, to which route it should go. The basic purpose of the network layer is to provide an end-to-end communication capability between the processes executing on different machines. Here I would like to add one thing, that it provides the communication, end-to-end communication. Network layer is also providing end-to-end communication. Transport layer is also providing end-to-end communication. But what is the difference? The difference is that in network layer, the end-to-end communication is done between the two computers, only between the two computers. But in transport layer, the end-to-end communication is done between the two processes. The two processes can be on the same computer, or it can be on the different computers, different network, whatever the location is. But the process is also important. These are the seven layers, as you can see on the screen: physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, and application layer. These are the seven layers, and we will start from the physical layer first. But before start, I will like to tell you that we will discuss this OSI model and each of the layers, but only the main functions of each of the layer. We will not go into deep in this video. And if you want to see the overall the functioning of each layer in detail, then wait for the upcoming videos. We will study each layer in detail in the upcoming videos. So let's start with the main functioning of each layer. Next is the presentation and application layer. Presentation layer determines the format used to exchange data among different networked computers. This layer is concerned with the syntax and semantics of the information transmitted. And the application layer provides applications with access to the network services. Whatever the network is providing the services, the application layer does the thing that it provides those facilities to the different applications. The applications can be email transferring, it can be web serving, it can be file uploading or downloading, whatever the application is. The application provides the facilities to access the network services. It has different protocols for each of the services. For example, if you want to send email, then there is a protocol called SMTP, which is the full form of SMTP, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, and you can send the emails through that protocol only. So different applications have different protocols. And for example, if we can talk about file transferring, then there is a protocol called FTP, which is every bit is a file transfer protocol, and we use that protocol to access those services, file transferring services. So these are the basic functions of each of the layers of OSI model, and to study in detail about each of the model, how they work, each of the layer, how do they work, then keep watching the upcoming videos. Thank you.